Okay, listen here. Alternator means AC generator. Alternator. Alternator means AC generator. He is saying that AC generator, a star connected alternator, is connected to a, I'm opening one second. The impedance of the load. He is giving the impedance of the load. What is the impedance of the load?
8 plus j6.
8 plus j6. Ohm per phase. Per phase means phase impedance. This is the delta connected load. Now your problem is related to delta connected, not the star connection. Star connection is only AC generator. Internal wiring of the AC generator is star connected. But your problem is related to delta connection. And the load impedance is this much. Line voltage is 230 volts. VL is 230. Now see here, I am drawing the delta connection first of all. First of all, I will draw the delta connection. That is 8 plus J6. See, this is 8 plus J6. This is 8 and J6. Okay. This is the first one. This is the starting point of the winding. This is the finishing point of the first winding. Starting point, finishing point. In delta, how we will connect? Second winding. Starting is connected to finishing of the. Finishing of first coil is connected to starting of the second coil. That is 8 and J6. This is finishing. Here also. This is starting and finishing. Okay, this is 8 and J6. This is the delta connection. This is the delta connection. Now see here, I am taking this one as one, phase one. Phase one. I am taking this one as phase two. See here, I1 is the line current. Let us take in the one phase one, I1 is the line current. Okay. Let us take I1 line current. And here I2 is the line current. And I3 is the line current. Otherwise, we'll call it as I1 L. You take L. I1L, I2L, I3L you take. L means line current. I1L is the line current. I2L is the line current. I3L is the line current. Now where are the phase currents? Phase current, let us take this is the first winding. This is the first winding. In the first winding, let us say current will flow from starting to finishing end. Current will flow. Let us take I1 is the phase current. I1 is the phase current. And this is the starting. This is the finishing end of second coil. And the I2 is the phase current. I2 is, I1 is phase current. I2 is phase current. And I3. This is the starting point. This is the finishing point. This is I3. Phase current. What is the line current? I3L. Okay, these are the three line currents, I1, IL, I1L, I2L, I3L. And what are the phase currents? I1, I2, and I3. Now, can you tell me, what is IL1 line current in terms of phase current from this diagram? This is the node point. This is the node point. IL1 is equal to, apply KCL here. Apply KCL. Incoming currents is equal to outgoing currents at a node point. Incoming current is equal to outgoing. What are the incoming currents in this node point?
IE1L and I3.
I1L and plus I3 is equal to outgoing current is I1. Now can you tell me the line current IL, I1L? I1L is equal to I1 minus
I3.
Okay. Now your line current IL I1 is equal to I1 and I3 are phase currents. I1 minus I3. Because at the node point current will divide. Now can you tell me the I2L line current I2L? This one. At this node point. At this node point. This node point.
I2 minus I3.
I2 minus
I1.
I1.
I2 minus I1. Next, similarly, I3L. This node point.
I3 minus I2.
I3 minus I2. Can you observe the one common conclusion from these three equations? Here, one is there, one is there. What is the, at this node point, one, this direction and this direction are same. This direction is okay. I1L is equal to I1 minus I3. I2L is equal to I2 minus I1 at this. I3L is equal to I3 minus I1, I2, I3. Left side you are having line current and right side phase current I1, I2, I3 minus at this node point, this branch, this node is connected to these two branches. This node is connected to these two branches. This node is connected to these two branches. These are the line currents. Is it clear diagram? Relate, okay. Now all yes, these are not, all these are not necessary for you for this problem. For the next problem, these equations are important. For the next problem, these formulas are important. This diagram is important. See I1. I1 is flowing like this. I1 is flowing like this. Observe here the diagram. I1 is flowing like this. I1 is flowing. This direction. I2 is also in the same direction, the line. See, I3 also in the same line. I1 like this, I2 like this, I3 like this. These are the line current, phase current, in line. I1 is in line, the direction. I2 is also in line, I3 is also in line. So this diagram you remember. Now we'll go to our problem. All these are not necessary for you for this problem. Next problem, these are important. Okay, what he is asking in the problem? He is giving line voltage. What is the line voltage he is giving? What is the line voltage he is giving? VL is the voltage in between two phases. That is VL is equal to. What is VL given? 230. Okay, now Z phase, they have given Z phase 8 plus J6 ohms. Convert it into polar form. Convert this into polar form. Take your calculators. What is the value?
Magnitude 10.
Angle?
36.86.
Ohms. What is phi?
36.86.
Whatever the angle you are getting for it, that is your power factor angle. Now see here, they have given VL is equal to 230. But in delta, what is our condition? Is it okay? in delta. VL is equal to V phase is equal to 230 volts. In delta, voltage will be same because delta is the parallel connection. Delta is your parallel connection. Okay, that is VL. Now I want the in the problem he is asking us to determine the current in load branch. He is asking us to determine the line current. He is asking us to determine line current. Directly, I cannot determine line current. I can determine the phase current. Directly, I can't determine line current. I can determine phase current because I know V phase and Z phase. V phase, Z phase, I know. But I don't know the, there is no concept of line impedance. That's why directly you can't determine line current. We can determine phase current. V phase is 230. Z phase is 10 at an angle 36.86. Can you tell me the answer for this? 230 by 10 is 36.86 at an angle. What is the unit? Ampere.
Ampere.
So this is your phase current. We can't directly determine line current because there is no concept of ZL. First, we'll determine phase current, then I'll go for the line current. Therefore, line current is equal to root 3 into I phase. Root 3 into I phase. Root 3 into 23. Take only magnitude because angle may differ for line current and phase current. Are you getting this?
39.8
ampere. Yes, sir. 39.8. Okay. Now see here. Next, he is asking power consumed. Power consumed means P. Power consumed means P. Power consumed by the load. P is equal to what is the formula? In star connection, we have discussed. What is the formula?
3VPH IPH cos phi.
3V phase I phase cos phi. What is the other formula?
2 3VL
IL cos phi.
What is the other formula? For single phase, it is I square R. For three phase, it will be 3 into I square R. But I is I phase. For single phase, it is I square R. For three phase, it is 3 into I square R. We know the value of R. What is the value of R given in the problem?
Eight, sir.
Eight. We can take any formula. So current is 23. R is 8. We can take this formula or this formula. Take any formula and solve it. We'll get the same answer. What is the unit?
Watts.
Watts. Next, he is asking power factor. What is the phi value we have taken in Z? What is phi?
36.86.
Okay. That will be, since it is an inductive circuit, your power factor will be lagging. If it is capacitive circuit, it will be leading. Since it is an inductive circuit, your power factor. Next, he is asking reactive power. Next, he is asking reactive power Q. What is the formula for Q? What do you get here?
sin phi.
Sin phi. R root 3 VL IL sin phi. R, what is another formula? For reactive power? Reactance, XL will come. Because we know Z is equal to R plus JXL. What is the value of XL? What is the value of XL?
6.
6. Here you will get 6. You can take any formula. For P, we will get R. For Q, we will get XL. For P, I will get R. For Q, I will get XL. If it is S, what we will get? I square Z. If it is S, we'll get 3 I square Z or 3 V face I face or root 3 VL IL for S. This is for S. But in the problem, he is not asking S. What is the value Q you'll get?
9522.
952?
9522.
What is the unit?
Volt amp.
Volt amp reactive, because this is the reactive power. For S, the unit is VA, volt ampere. For S, the unit is VA, but for Q, the unit is VAR. For P, the unit is watts. Actually, what is S? P plus JQ. S is equal to P plus JQ. VA, watts, VAR. That's all about the problem. It is a new. So this is the solution they have given in the problem in your textbook. Your reactive power is 9513, they have given. Calculations may be wrong in your textbook. Calculations may be wrong in your textbook. Your power factor is 0.8. And your active power P is 12,000. Whatever you have got, that is your right answer. They have done the calculations wrong here. Okay. We'll go to the next problem. Take down this problem. A 220 volt three phase voltage is applied to your delta connected. Write down this problem.
Done, sir.
Okay. See here, in the problem he is saying 220 volts. What is 220 volts? Line voltage.
Line voltage.
Always in the problem they will give line voltage only. Always remember that. Write down VL is equal to 220 volts. But in delta connection, VL is equal to V phase is equal to 220 volts. Write down VL is equal to V phase is equal to 220 volts. Is connected to a delta connected load of 15 plus J20. See here. I'm drawing the diagram first of all. This is your phase current I1. This is your phase current I1. Now I am taking second phase, that is I2. This is I2. Next one is I3. This is your I3. Okay. This is one. Three phases we are having. This is the three phase connection. In the problem, he is saying three phase load. This is your three phase load. And your line voltage is 220 volts. Your VL is equal to V phase. VL is equal to V phase, 220 volts. He is asking phasor current. Phase current, I1 is I1, I2 or I3. Magnitude will be same, but angle will differ. Okay. How can you determine the phase current? I phase, V phase by Z phase. V phase by Z phase. First of all, write down Z phase is equal to 15 plus J20. Convert this to polar form. Convert this to polar form.
Twenty-five
at an angle.
Fifty-three point one three.
This is your impedance. Now, VL in delta connection, in delta, VL is equal to V phase, that is 220 volts. Directly, I can determine the line current. I can determine the phase current. That is 220 by 25. Are you getting 8.8?
Yes, sir.
That is the phase current. Now see here. Line current is equal to root 3 into I phase. Root 3 into I phase. You will get 15.24 ampere, root 3 into I phase. I phase is 8.8. I phase is 8.8. Okay. Have you written?
15.24.
24, okay. Now, what he is asking in the problem, what else?
Phasor current.
Phasor current. Okay, phasor diagram we'll draw later. Second bit, what is the second bit?
Power consumed per phase.
Power consumed per phase, I had told three formulas for this. Three I phase square R, R 3 VI cos phi, 3 V phase I phase cos phi, root 3 VL IL cos phi. You can take any formula and tell me the answer. R value is 15 here. Your R is 15. R is 15. Your R is 15. XL is 20. Your XL is 20 here.
One zero four five one point five nine.
Is it correct? Everyone is getting the same answer. Verify it. I think we won't get that much value.
No, sir, wrong.
Tell me. 462 watts you are getting? I don't know how much you are getting. 1162?
I phase we have to take only 8.8, no sir.
Oh, current is 8.8. 3 into 8.8 square into 15. R is 15.
3484.8.
3484.8. 8 watts. This is your power. Okay. This is your three-phase power. Now we'll go for the phasors. Now see here. Let us take this is I1. I1 is equal to I phase. I1 is equal to I phase. Now we know this is I1. This will be I2. Phase currents. I am drawing the phase currents. This is your I3. Okay. Now I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3. Magnitude 8.8. Magnitude is same. This is I1. Let us take 0 degrees. Then what is this angle?
120.
Minus 120. Why minus 120?
Clockwise.
It is in the clockwise direction. Now, if you move in the anti-clockwise direction for this, what is the angle for I3?
120.
Plus 120. If you move in the clockwise direction, what is the angle for I3?
240.
Minus 240 is equal to plus 120. We can take anything. We can take plus 120 or minus 240. For I3, if you move in the anti-clockwise direction, it is plus 120. If you move in the clockwise direction, one minus. For I1, how much you got? Minus. Okay. For I1, we got minus 53.13. For I2, what is the angle? I am adding minus 53.1 for all this. For I3 also, 120. I am taking plus 120. Minus 53.13. For I1, what is the angle? Minus 53.13. For I2, what is the angle?
Minus 173.13.
Minus 173.13. For I3,
66.83.
66.83. Minus or plus? Plus.
66.87, sir.
Okay, 66. Whatever you are getting, you take this. 66.87. Okay. Now I have determined the phase currents. I1 is 8.8 at an angle, this one. I2 is 8.8 at an angle, minus 173.13. Your I3 is 8.8 at an angle, 66.87. Now see in your textbook, I am sharing the screen. See your I1, RYB they are taking. I1 is equal to 8.8 at an angle minus 53.8. This is, they have given wrong here. Some printing mistakes, error are there. 8.8 at an angle minus 53. We have got 53.13. For I2, we have got 8.8 at an angle minus, how much is this one? Minus 173.13. Minus 173.13. For I3, what you got?
66.8.
See here, 8.8 is the magnitude. Your angle is 66.87. Okay. These are the phase currents. I1, I2 and I3 are the phase currents. Your I1, I2, I3 are the phase currents. Okay. Next, we will go for the line currents. See the line current, I1. Here they are taking, we have changed the notations. Take it as, now see here on the board. Board is visible? Is board visible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
See here, this is IL1. What is IL1 at this node point? What is IL1 from this diagram?
I1 minus I3.
I1 minus I3. Similarly, IL2 is equal to I2 minus I1. IL3 is equal to I3 minus I2.
Okay.
Now we know I1, I2 and I3. Now I know I1, I2 and I3. See your I1 is 8.8 at an angle minus 53.1. Convert this to rectangle form. Convert this to rectangle form.
X is equals to 5.2, sir. 5.28.
5.28.
Minus 7.03.
7.03. 03 ampere. Now again convert this. Are you getting the I2? This 173.13? I2?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now tell me I2 value. Rectangle form.
Minus 8.73, sir. X value.
Okay. Y value?
Minus 1.05.
This is your I2 value. Now tell me I3 value. I3 value.
Seventy-two point zero
plus J
95.99.
What is the value? I think you have told wrong answer. Verify properly. I3 value
95.99.
Everybody is getting that answer? In your textbook, they have given different answer.
So you change the angle, sir. Instead of 66, take a negative. Instead of taking 66, take negative angle, like clockwise direction.
Okay, no problem. We'll get here REC 8.88 comma 66.87. Are you now tell me what is this value? REC 8.8 comma 66.87 in your calculator. Can anyone repeat the answer?
X is equals to 3.45.
3.45 plus J. 8.09,
sir.
8.1 ampere. Okay. Now I know I1, I2 and I3. See in your textbook now. I'm showing on the screen. This is I1 value. This is I2 value. Some signs are missing here. This is I3 value. Now I know I1, I2 phase currents. I1, I2, I3. Now see on the board line currents. IL1 is equal to I1 minus I3. Take down. IL1 is equal to your I1 is 5.28 minus J7.03 minus of your I3 is 3.45 plus J8.1. Add the real parts and add the imaginary parts here. 5.28 minus 3.45. 5.28 minus 3.45. Similarly, IL2. Similarly, IL3. Don't see the textbook answers. In textbook, they might have given wrong. Whatever you are doing, that is your correct procedure. For 5.28 minus 3.45, how much?
1.83
minus J7.03 minus J8.1. Minus J?
15.13.
This is your line current, ampere. If you want to convert to polar, see in your textbook, they have given the answer. See the screen. I1 is equal to 1.72 minus J, 15.13. 1.72 minus J, 15.13. If you convert it to polar form, this is the answer for line current I1. This is the line current I1. Is it okay? Similarly, we can do IL2 and IL3. IL2 is, we know I2 and I1. Phase current I2 and I1 we know. IL3 is equal to phase current I3 and I2. So these are the line currents. Okay, convert it to polar form IL1. Convert it to polar form IL1. How much you will get? Are you getting this? Textbook answer are you getting? Is it okay? Polar form. Convert IL1 rectangle to polar form. Are you getting the answer? Okay. Now IL2. Stop writing for 1 minute. I'll see the screen. Please see the screen. So line current magnitude is same. See, 15.23, 15.47, 15.26. Approximately magnitude will be same. We have to get the same magnitude, but angle will differ. But angle will differ. -83.5, -156.8, 36.8. So by using these angles, we can draw the phasor diagram. By using these angles, we can draw the phasor diagram. Okay, that's all about the problem. That's all about the problem. See the C bit. If you add I1 plus I2 plus I3, we'll get zero. Some see here, example 19.15. Is it visible, example 19.15?
Yes, sir.
Now see, this is the assignment problem to you. Already you have done the problem on star and delta connection. See, three similar coils. Resistance is 20 ohm, R is 20, inductance L is 0.05 Henry. We have to determine XL. How will determine XL for this? How will determine XL? Because it is Henry, R is in ohms. We had to convert this Henry to ohms. XL we had to determine. What is the formula for XL?
Omega C.
Omega L. That is XL is equal to, see here answer they are giving. XL is
equal
to
1 by
omega. No, if not XC, they are telling the inductance. Inductance means omega L. XL is 2 pi FL. See here. Write down note for this problem. Example 19.15 is the assignment to you. So here we want XL. XL is 2 pi FL. F is 50 hertz. See, they are giving frequency is 50. In the problem, he is giving frequency is 50. So therefore, XL is equal to 2 pi FL. L is 0.05. That is equal to 15 ohms. We will get XL is 50. Write down. If you are having confusion, means write down here. XL is equal to, write down, write down question number 19.15 and write down XL is equal to 2 pi FL. XL is equal to 2 pi, F is frequency 50, L is 0.05 Henry. If you multiply this, you will get 15 ohms. Write down XL is 15 ohms. What is R value? What is R?
20.
Now draw the diagram for star connection. R is 20, XL is 15. R is 20, XL is 15. 15 ohms. 20, 15 ohms. Okay. You should not write L value here 0.05 Henry because the unit of L is not here ohms. We had to convert this into ohms. XL is 2 pi FL. That is 15 ohms. 15 ohms. Now what is the line voltage he has given in the problem? What is the line voltage?
400 volts.
400 volts. See here, phase to phase line voltage. In between phase and neutral, this is phase voltage. 400 by root 3 is 231. Your phase voltage is 231. In between phase and neutral. In between phase to phase line voltage. Always in the problem, they will give line voltage. Okay. Now remaining is, first they are asking star connection. Next they are asking delta connection. Mesh means delta connection. Calculate the power and line current. If you want the line current directly, you cannot determine line current. First you have to determine phase current. Both for star and delta. See here. First they are calculating for star connection. In star connection, VL is equal to root 3 into V phase. V phase is equal to VL by root 3. But in delta, VL is equal to V phase. In delta connection, VL is equal to V phase. In star connection, IL is equal to I phase. So calculate the values. So example 19.15 is the assignment to you. Take down the question. Already you have done this type of problem in both in star connection and delta connection. Similar problem this one. Example 19.15. Next example 19.16 also. Example 19.16. Similar problem. This type of problem we had done. In this problem, they are asking to determine the circuit elements, I think. Impedance. Impedance means circuit elements and impedance is also. This type of problem also we had done, both in star connection, star and delta connection. Example 19.16 is also assignment. Okay, these two are the assignment problems. Example 19.15 and 19.16. If you do these two problems, with this we have completed our star delta networks. With this we have completed our second unit. Second unit is completed. Okay, I have given two problems assignment to you. Example 19.15 and 19.16. Very simple problems. You can do this. So wait, I will take the attendance. So these are the options. Now I am ending the class. So in mid exam, we'll have first two units, first unit and second unit. I have given 25 questions to you. Please go through those 25 questions. From those 25 questions, you'll get the questions in the exam. Okay, now you can exit.